Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are here. Another Tuesday. Another blah day, as some may call it. But like I always say, like any other day, you gotta get up and do something. For me, growing up in Brooklyn, New York during the 90s was hard. I grew up with being asked to sell drugs and join gangs was a daily thing. I was bullied and threatened and harassed and attacked. I grew up around so much violence, but I am fortunate enough to see many days after those crazy nights. I grew up living in a studio apartment with two windows, five people, one bunk bed, and no bedrooms, and a curfew that read, don't let me or anybody I know see you in those streets, or else hails of smacks and belts will rain come down. I grew up living poor, real poor. I'm talking about eating bread and water alone poor. Opening the fridge and wondering if I can eat the baking soda poor. $2 weekly allowance poor. I used to wear Sega sneakers. You know, the ones with the lights in them. That were hand-me-down for my brother poor. I'm talking about recycling two jeans and four shirts every week for school poor. Poor like saving my school lunch for dinner poor. I grew up poor. And I'm not just talking about poor financially. I'm talking about poor in knowledge. Poor in my study habits. Poor in wanting a better future for myself. Poor at writing down my goals and holding myself accountable. Poor at self-motivation. Poor at trying again after I failed. Poor at doing the right thing. I grew up poor at life. But you see, here's what growing up poor and having that hard life taught me. It taught me that I have a story to tell. It also taught me that whoever has experienced being poor in any way or lack of opportunities has their story to tell. This hard life gives us a unique opportunity. It teaches us so many lessons. It allows us to scratch and claw and die to get what we want. And it forces us to make a choice. A choice that every successful person you see had to make at some point in their lives. A choice that I challenge you to make today. I challenge you to believe. Believe in yourself. Believe in the goals that you set for yourself. Believe that whatever it is that you have been thinking about, waiting to start, worrying about failing, or doubting yourself to accomplish, believe that it is possible. So what? You're working on that degree and it's hard and it's taken 5, 6, 7, 8 years to accomplish. Believe in yourself. So what? You got fired or let go of that job that pays all of your bills. You have to believe that things will work in your favor. So what? Everyone is doubting that great idea that you have, that world-changing idea that no one has ever thought of. You have got to believe that you can do it. Ask any successful person today, and 100% of them, not 9 out of 10, not most, not some, all of them would say, to succeed in anything in life, you have got to believe in yourself, because they know above all else, above, around, below, the great words like passion and love and not quitting and perseverance, at the core of it is belief. And I think that Robert Bolton said it best in saying, a belief is not merely an idea the mind possesses. It is an idea that possesses the mind. And it is that very understanding, that very conclusion, that very choice that I have to challenge myself to make to get out of that poor mentality, that mindset where I let other people decide on my abilities and capabilities, and I let their limitations become mine. So like a Nat Turner, a Barack Obama, a Steve Jobs, a Thomas Edison, or that guy or girl that you grew up with, that you now see living their dreams, believe in you. Believe and be unrealistic. Believe through the unforeseen. For those who believe, no proof is necessary. But for those who don't believe, no proof is possible.